Let us pause for a moment and call to mind our sins and ask loving God for pardon and mercy. Together we pray.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my faults. Therefore, I ask the blessed Mary of the Virgin, for all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to the last end.
Amen.
Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relate in remembrance, we may also hold in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As Peter reached the house, Cornelius went out to meet him, knelt at his feet, and prostrated before him himself. But Peter held him up. "Stand up," he said, "I'm only a man after all." Then Peter addressed them. "Truth have now come to realize," he said, "is that God does not have favorite, but that anybody of any nationality who fears God and does what is right is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking, the Holy Spirit came down on all and listened. Jewish believers who had accompanied Peter were all astonished that the gift of the Holy Spirit should be poured out on the pagans too. Since they could hear them speak in strange languages and proclaiming the greatness of God, Peter himself then said, "Could anyone refuse the water of baptism to these people? No, they have received the Holy Spirit just as much as we have." He then gave orders for them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Afterwards, they begged him to stay on for some days. Word of the Lord.
And speak to God.
All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. All the ends of the earth, all the creatures of the sea,
from the letter of St. John. My dear people, let us love one another, since love comes from God. And everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Anyone who fails to love can never have known God, because God is love. God's love for us was revealed when God sent into the world his only Son, so that we could have life through him. This is the love I knew, not our love for God, but God's love for us, when he sent his Son to be the sacrifice that takes our sins away. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
Jesus said to the disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I've told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I've told you everything I've heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appointed you to one bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This is my command: love one another." My sisters and brothers, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Love is a flowing
On this, the sixth Sunday of Easter, our readings speak first and foremost to the formation of the Christian community. It's speaking of what we are doing now and how it came to be. The scripture also tells us that for that Christian community to have survived, they lived in love and unity. It was a trademark. It was something very different from every other community in that time. The love of God was with the community. And the love of God that was with that community is the same love of God that we have. It's a love that is freely given to us so that we might freely share it with others. Friends, God is love. God is love, and all that God has to do with us resembles that love. And too often we make the mistake about love to be feeling. It's because I feel like you love me, I love him back. Woman, amen. It's not only a feeling, my dear friends. The love is an action. True love is always about relationship. It's always showing actions that you really love the other person. We are often in life that there are three types of friends. There are friends for a reason, friends for a season, and friends for a lifetime. And a friend for a reason often stay in a relationship seeking how they can benefit from that relationship. A friend for a season is only there while things are going well. And there are friends for a lifetime who are there when you didn't have anything and are still with you now. You know, Jamaican woman always says, "I'm a lover, I'm a little friend." You ever hear that before? The love is here because it's your friend. And love and friendship, therefore, goes deep. You know, when Karen Cameron's mother died and I spoke to her, and I simply asked the question, "How are you dealing with this?" She said, "Father, I lost a best friend." Full stop. I said, "Calm down in her head." It would have been the same. When you lose a friend, it tells a lot. You lose something deep. Jesus is coming to us this morning and he's saying, "You are my friends. I don't love you because the Father sent me to love you. I love you because you're my friend. And I'm going to give everything of me for you." He's saying to us that he's coming to us as disciples out of love, and he wants us to enter into a relationship with him. He doesn't want us to see him as a friend for a season or a friend for a reason. Jesus comes to us this morning and he's saying, "I am your friend for a lifetime." He's a friend for a lifetime. He's saying that he's calling us friends because he loves us. I'm calling you friends because I want you to be happy and to be filled with joy as I am. I'm calling you friends because I was at the transfiguration where I saw and got a taste of heaven, and because I love you, I want to enter into a relationship with you so you can see heaven as well. And so this morning, God comes and he says, "Keep my commandments, remain my love." It's not as if he's saying to you with a wagging finger, "You better do this or else." He's saying to us, in that same love and friendship that I have for you, I want you to come to heaven. I want you to enjoy the milk and honey and the streets of gold that we often hear about. But he's really saying, there's much more to this life after this. But the only way we can attain it is love. This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. And Jesus continues by saying, how can you love God whom you do not see if you do not love your brother and sister whom you can see? How would you rate your relationship with Jesus this morning? If you could put it on a scale of 1 to 10, what number would you give that relationship? And whatever number you have given that relationship, how was the relationship with Jesus made a difference in your life? first reading from the Acts of the Apostles and the life and work of St. Peter in interaction with Cornelius. And in this interaction, it is saying that we're all called to be loving to one another. Not to be judgmental, not to be territorial, not to be it's me and myself, but we're all called to be one. And we're reminded that as church, we're indeed Catholic. And Catholic means what? Universal. And the Greek word for Catholic means one. It means united as one in God. And so our scripture is saying to this morning, as I started in the beginning, it's a community of one. But a community can only continue its mission if it remains as one. If it breaks, love's moved, love is gone through the door, it cannot function as a community it's called to be. And so I keep dropping these hints at us, not to say that it's a divided church. Not because every Sunday I come and tell it to be one, meaning that we're not one. I'm saying to us this morning, and I'm saying to us over time, is that as church, we need to be one to do the mission. If we're not one, then all we're going to do is come on a Sunday morning and just spend a little 2 hours and then go home. And is that what we come here for? Is that what we come here for? Is that what we want to live? We want to live as a church and a mission. And so, I want to tell you this morning, don't let nothing come between you being church and living church. And I said being church and living church because oftentimes persons understand church to be what? 8.5 keys in Avenue, something like that. It's not, this is church, you know. This is church building. This is church property. Church is you and I. And when they leave church, it's when they bring it home. It's when people come to you and say, Pam, how you doing? And instantly Pam starts talking about Jesus. It's church is when they can go home and the person say, why are you so happy? What is that joy? And they start talking about what? Jesus makes me complete. And it's in that completeness of God why I'm happy. Is that why you're happy this morning, brothers and sisters? Jesus is the reason why we have church and we're called to live it. Today, as we progress through the Easter season, as we come to an end of this Easter, we rejoice freely in God's resurrection. We rejoice in His glory. All of us as one church, the member of the same body, living the church in this world. And we're reminded that we all share in the generous and the wonderful love of God. And through Christ, our Lord Jesus Christ. And as John says, God has shown His love in the flesh. And He's shown His love in the flesh, and He comes to dwell with us, within us, and among us. And that His love remains with us always, at all times. And so, my brothers and sisters in Christ, that is why we're called be a mission. That is why we're called to evangelize, to proclaim the truth, because we have received the love of God, not for ourselves, but to share it. We're called to do our best in our lives. We're called to do our best to be people of love. We're called to be filled with love for God, first and foremost, and love for our fellow brothers and sisters, for all who we meet and encounter in this life. Strangers and the known. That is what we're called for. Now, are we willing to commit ourselves to this cause? Are we willing to share the love that we have received? You know, in this present world, and this week more than ever, aside from some meetings I had with people in different communities, there's bitterness, there's hatred. I don't know if you ever realized that. See, there are some persons in this world are bitter and they are hateful. And in this bitterness and hatred, we as Christians are called to do what? Bring love, mercy, and compassion. And I'm not canonizing myself, I'm not making myself a saint this morning. But to be honest, all I could say when the bitterness and hatred come was, where's the love? Are you going to live like this forever?
Are you going to hate your neighbor? And to be honest, persons just stopped and reflected on it. But we have to constantly tell people that we're called to be what? People of love. And if we as Christians fail to tell people that, guess what? We fail altogether. We have to keep reminding the world we live in that we're called to love. The world has enough pain and suffering. And it is up to us as Christians to show genuine love, which is a reflection of God's love to all we meet. And we may not show the love like I did by saying it, but we say it as a love in action. We do it. Oftentimes, we as Christians, the way we live our life towards others, it's not that we're selfish, but we say to ourselves, let me just stay over here and you over there. Is that showing love? Sometimes as Christians, persons come to us and they're telling us about their relationship with God or how God has been there for them. And all we give is a Shut up now. None of us have done that before. But we're called to really be there in action, loving action. As a mother, as we celebrate Mother's Day today, I think it's perfect that we're hearing about love. And I think the best way for us to understand God's love is through the birth process of a mother. In after 9 months, you lose your shape, eh? Lose all of that. Say amen, ladies. Because I know you suffer when you lose it. When you're going to the hospital after a pain in your stomach, and you're told it's time, and you're stripped of beer, and some people are smiling, and others are being normal, just doing their jobs, and you're there saying to yourself, never again. Amen? We're not doing this again. It's amazing some people go 10 and 11 times, eh? But when you meet the fruit of your womb, all that pain goes away. And you find it hard to let go of a child, and you have that unconditional love. Not true. That is the love that Christ emanated for us. Pain, bear on a cross, some laughing, some doing their job. But he did it all because at the end of it, unconditional love. And so on this Mother's Day, the best representation of true love are you, my lady friends. Today, you show Jesus' love in the world. And so anytime you feel as if this love that you have given, or this love that you have to pass on, is not being respected, not being cherished, appreciated, remind yourself this. Your unconditional love is joined to the love of the cross. The cross that brings us salvation. And so today, I thank you for saying yes. I thank you for bringing a child into the world that is not just an act of love, but an act of hope. Hope that your child will contribute greatly to society. And so on today, Mother's Day, keep being a good mother. And today, keep showing love. And even when love is not given back to you, keep on loving. Men, the few of us here today, we cannot kiss or hug the mothers, but I hope we can say to them, thank you. Because truly, you are the face of love. Amen.
Let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God. Show our love for Him and for the Father by loving one another. By our love, the power of Christ, the Christ's resurrection, is made known to the world. Let us now turn to the Father with our prayers for the church and for the world.
In response, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer.
That the church may continue to proclaim the message of Christ's love to all with clarity and for the Pope Francis and the leaders of the Church in their ministry, will be blessed by God and hallmarked with courage, compassion, and truth. Lord, in your mercy. For all the people in the world, that they may rejoice in the gift of love, and that hatred and rejection may come to an end. Lord, in your mercy. For all mothers that go to the intercession of Mary, the Lord will bless them and reward them for their sacrifices and love. Lord, in your mercy. For all who are sitting or preparing for exams, that the Holy Spirit will guide them to use their gifts wisely and well. Lord, in your mercy.
Send your spirit of truth into our hearts, that we may always reject what is false, live by the command of Christ, and be true to the love you have shown us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Collection hymn number 384. That's 384. There's supposed to be a second collection for the
expenses of the
archdiocese. The second collection. Tell of my love to the island, tell it everywhere, show all your brothers and sisters of father's love and care. Brothers who are seeking, living in the night, sisters who are weeping.
acceptable to God and Almighty Father.
In the Lord, Church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offering, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just our duty of salvation at all times to obey you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and his rising, the life of all, has risen. Therefore, overcome with pastoral joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Jesus who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to suffer the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in most holy sacraments. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen. Communion hymn number 303, that's 303, oh the love of my Lord is the essence.
Every day, every hour.
number 132, as 132. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of you.
Thank you.
love me, keep my commandments, says the Lord. And I will ask the Father, and he will send you another Paraclete to abide with you forever. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Almighty and living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this pastoral sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated. So I'm going to ask the mothers to please stand. And as you stand, I'm going to pray for you and give you some blessings and ask that you just bow your head. Jesus, we ask you on this Mother's Day to pray for our own dear mothers. May your Son Jesus reward them for all the care they have so lovingly given to us over the years. May he give them peace of heart for all the time they have soothed us in the times of trouble and failure. Lord, we pray for all mothers, beautiful and wonderful, they fill the earth. Gracious in your call that they carry life, in a bond of love they bring forth a child. We ask you to bless all the mothers today. May they feel the joys of motherhood every day. In all their struggles, giving us a livelihood. May your love and compassion be with them forever. And may every mother feel today the pride and beauty of a family they bear. We ask all of this to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We come to give a blessing while you are serenaded and hear Christ.
Thank you.
again. Just chill out today, all right? No cooking, no nothing. Let's go home and chill out. If you have a husband, he can beg your pardon. If you have a husband like he can, you forget what I just said about the cooking part. But have a wonderful day, all of you mothers.
Most welcome.
For just a few announcements. The first one is on May 22nd, where we are ordination to the priesthood of two men, one Deacon Francis Musoka and Deacon Joseph Campbell. So both of them will be ordained on the 22nd at the cathedral at 10 a.m. The Zoom link will be sent out because still mindful of the 30 protocols, only their close family, a few priests, and the Archbishop will be present. So Zoom link will be posted in the WhatsApp group and all the mediums for those who'd like to attend. Weekday Mass is still 5:30 here on the Wednesdays. On Wednesdays, you're all invited. With sadness and remorse, we announce the death of Deacon Carl Garrell, who was ordained in 2010, and he served as St. Peter, Paul, and St. Martin the Porus. Very good guy, very good guy. But he just took ill and passed off a week or 2 weeks later. He's now with his beautiful wife Sheila, who died just 2 years ago. So we pray for his soul. I pray after the Mass on this morning. So we'll continue to pray for his soul. Is there anyone celebrating a birthday today? I have here Mr. Paul Anthony Neal, the father of William Neal. So Paul, I don't know if he's online today, he's usually there. So happy birthday to you, Paul. May God bless you richly and peace today, your day of birth. Any anniversary, wedding anniversary? Or Deacon last week wasn't here, but he's here this week with the wife. So we do the blessing this week. Yes? Deacon, you may approach.
Years. Wow. Wonderful. Okay.
Here's to you. Here's to me. Here's to
celebrate another anniversary, Lord, that you continue to bless them. Continue to give them every grace in persevering in this union. We ask you to bless their family, bless their children, give them good health and long life. We ask, O Lord, that others may look upon them, see the sign of love, and also emulate it in the world. We ask you to bless them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Sister Blossom said it's not 54, but she's not yet 50. So, Deacon, do you see the same day? Yes? So you can take off your mask and give a holy kiss. No corona not there. Praise God. Praise God. Happy anniversary. Stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration is ended. Go forth in peace, glorify the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Have a wonderful Sunday, everyone.
Thank you, Father. Our recessional hymn is hymn number 335. That's 335, redeemed by the precious blood of the Lamb. That's hymn number 335. Redeemed by the precious blood of the Lamb.